I suppose you fellows remember I did once turn freshwater sailor for a bit. You ought to know how I got to be one, in order to understand its effects on me. When I was a little boy, I had a passion for maps. I would look for hours at South America, or Africa, or Australia, and lose myself in the glories of exploration. At the time, there were many blank spaces on the earth, and when I saw one that looked particularly inviting, I put my finger on it. But by this time, a white patch for a boy to dream had become a place of darkness. One thing remained to do. Say goodbye to my excellent aunt, bless her dear enthusiastic soul. She talked about weaning those ignorant millions from their hard ways till she made me feel quite uncomfortable. It's queer how out of touch women are, some confounded fact that we men have been living contentedly with ever since the day of creation. You must understand, it was a continental concern, but I have a lot of relations living in the continent, because it's cheap, not so nasty as it looks, they say. I was not used to getting things that way, you know? I always went my own route, and all my own lakes, where I had a mind to go. But who am I to complain? She's the woman, after all, who provided the opportunity to visit such a place.
Marlow?
Yes, Aunt?
Where, Fernando?
And write often.
I will.
I cannot forget my young days, though. There was in one river especially, a mighty big river that you could see on a map, resembling an immense snake uncoiled, with its head in the sea, its body at rest, curving afar over the vast country, and its tail lost in the depths of the land.
Darn it!